My name is Jerry Manning. I am retired. I am a retired attorney. I worked in the public defender's office for 33 years. I've had 3 kidney transplants, and I went back to work after the first 2. When I had the 3rd one, I was already retired. I participated in a study at Vanderbilt for people who had hypertension. And they monitored me for about 1.5 years before they made the decision that I needed to go on dialysis. And then when they told me what the symptoms were, I was not symptomatic enough for it to bother me. And so I held off for another 1/2 year before I made the decision that I would go on dialysis. When I made the decision to go on dialysis, I had started to experience symptoms. I was fatigued. It was probably not safe for me to drive because I would fall asleep at the red lights. I had a bad taste in my mouth. My skin started to itch. And when I started experiencing those things, then I took their recommendation and told them I was ready. All 3 were cadaver donors. The last one was a young person who had experienced some kind of trauma, and that person had been on life support for a while. And when his family took him off life support, they donated his organs, and I was able to get one of his kidneys. Well, first off, you're free. You don't have big chunks of your day taken up by sitting in that chair in a dialysis clinic. And you feel better. You do have regimens that you have to follow, and it's important that you follow those regimens. And so that's not time consuming like the dialysis. And you feel like you have your life back.
These are my medications that I take daily, and I take some of them twice a day. And yeah, it's a lot. As well as having to monitor your blood pressure, weight, and temperature every day.
That medication is extremely important because some of the medications prevent infection. Some of the medications regulate how the kidney is functioning, and you've got to take them, and you've got to take them on that schedule. That's important. If you start slipping on that schedule, then things can happen to that kidney. And some kidneys go into a slow decline like mine did. It took my kidney like 4 years before it wasn't functional anymore. And some kidneys go into a rapid decline. And so it's important that you take that medicine like they tell you to. The pros are you feel like you have your life back. You feel better. Nobody's poking you, sticking you every other day. The cons are the kidneys are fragile. And the people that I work with, the professionals that I work with, were very careful to tell me that having a kidney transplant was not a cure, it was a treatment. And that it's important that you follow the regimens, do what the doctors say, and take care of yourself overall. It's your responsibility to take care of your health. And so you can't take chances with your kidney. So that's the con, just kind of worried about, am I doing the right thing? Am I eating the right thing? Am I getting enough exercise? Am I taking my medication on time? And so you have to always be mindful that that kidney is fragile, and it doesn't take a whole lot for the kidney to start to decline.